Thank you. Well, that was an old classic, Steel Dre Day. That was the instrumental I was playing. Damn, so you mean to tell me I was listening to the whole instrumental the whole time while we downtown? Well, I hope y'all enjoyed it and everything else, man.
Ain't nothing wrong with switching it up.
Yeah, ain't nothing wrong with switching it up, man. They heard the instrumental. That's cool. That's all right. We broadcasting live down here at the 440 right here in the Financial District. We just had a guest walk up, man. You want to introduce him, Donte? You know, this is one of Donte's guests that he brought on through. Go ahead. Talk to the people, man.
Hey, what's going on? I got my mans here, the phenomenal, prolific, King Deuce. You might have heard him before, but we're going to let you get reintroduced, man. Go ahead and say something on the mic, man.
I'm on the camera, so I got to, like, move around. I feel like I'm hustling, man, and shit. What up, though?
Well, what's good, man? I know we over here at your job and stuff like that, man. We won't get you in trouble, but we want you to whisper on the mic a little bit, you know what I'm saying?
Man.
Don't get us live, man.
One fish, two fish. Red fish, blue fish. Stuffed chicken roof, Chris.
We're going to take him off the mic, man.
Yeah.
We're going to let him get back to work, man. But this is what we doing. This is what we doing down here, man. We're going to broadcast live everywhere we go and just let people talk on the mic. That was Donte's buddy, man. He actually rapping everything else, so, you know, he can't really get deep into the interview like we really want to. They got him on a corporate watch today, but we're gonna get him in, man. You got some music out there that people need to hear or whatever you want to put out there? Go going. That's what we want you to do. Tell that, man.
H Deuce, YouTube, H.Deuce. You can just type that in. I'm there, well, YouTube, Twitter. Instagram, H_Deuce. Facebook, H Deuce.
You on Periscope too?
Chat, H Deuce. Periscope, H_Deuce. Just Deuce life, man. I'm man with.
That's what you're talking about. Y'all just got a small dose of the Deuce life. So we're going to say deuces to you right now because you know you got to get back to work. But we go have Ace Deuce on here, man. Just a small promotion and everything. We broadcasting live down here and everything else. We going to be out here for a minute, man. So, you know, if you get off, you want to get back on and talk, bro, we're going to be out here, man. You know, you can tune in on the app and listen to us live, too, man. Get us some listeners. But go on Spreaker.com and just type in Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment.
So y'all know we live, you know.
Talk to the YGM information, man. Talk to the people. You want to talk about who? Buddy Ryan. So go ahead and talk about
him. God rest his soul. One of the most defensive minds, or one of the best defensive minds ever in the NFL. You know him. He was the 85 coach, defensive coach of the 85 Bears, who won that Super Bowl, that stifling defense, one of the best, if not the best, ever. You know he was having health problems all through the years and everything like that. It really didn't come to a shock, but he still is going to be missed. He was well-respected by his players. I mean, he really got a fine-tuned old machine when he had his players and everything. He was no nonsense, though. And I know him and Dickie had problems, but it is what it is, you know. And I know his sons, my heart goes out to his sons and everything, and they are defensive minds, too, coming from their dad. So, yeah.
So, remembering that whole Bears run, do you think that was one of the best defenses we ever saw established?
Oh, no doubt.
Because, you had the steel curtain, even though we didn't get a chance to see it, but us being sports fans, we went off, and me personally, I went off and, like, watched small videos and plus talking to, like, old heads and everything else. You know how old heads is. You know how it is. We getting old. Ain't no time better than our time. So you know what I'm saying? I got a chance to listen to about the steel curtain and everything else. Who else had a nice defense? Cleveland. Cleveland had a nice defense back in like the 60s and everything. So I got a chance to like to see like different like defenses, but lie personally, I got to say the Bears is probably one of the best defenses I've seen so far since me understanding football. You get what I'm saying?
I mean, if you look at what happened last year with Denver Broncos, The measuring stick is the Bears, the 85 Bears. And they revolutionized with that 86 defense.
Yeah. No, not the 86, you mean the 46.
46 defense, my bad. 46 defense. And how they got at you, you know. It was something that no other team's ever seen before. And it caught everybody off guard. They still use that now, I believe. I mean, it's not as potent as it used to be, but it is effective. But it was revolutionary when he brought it aboard, you know. So,
a lot of defensive schemes and a lot of offensive schemes are starting to make a comeback. Like, what was that West Coast offense that San Francisco had? What was the coach name? And it took off. I think it was it running.
Bill Walsh.
Was it Bill Walsh?
Yeah, but it was the West Coast offense.
Yeah, the West Coast offense. But what he had a specific name for? Was it the West Coast offense he had a name for?
Yeah, that's what he called it.
But who was it that they had a similar type of offense? I don't want to say the wrong thing, but it's like he revolutionized it. He what the fuck was he down in San Diego? I'm gonna get that information for you. But I know Bill Walsh started the.
Is it recent coach?
It was a recent coach. I can't think of his name.
Norv Turner, was it?
Was it Norv Turner? I was reading it somewhere, man. I can't remember, but I'm going to get that information for you. But a lot of old, like, offensive schemes and defensive schemes are starting to come back, and a lot of coaches are starting to revolutionize them a little bit, man. All this stuff look the same, right or wrong.
I mean, yeah, it's always this variation of an old tactic, but it's the same. Just a little tweaks and turns over there, but it's all the same.
You know, so, I mean, we seeing a lot of what we done seen before. I'm trying to pull up this little app, pull up a little something while we sitting here talking. We are going live right here on Bring It A-Game Sports Talk Radio. We broadcasting live down here in the Financial District over here by the 440. We're going to be out here for a minute since we're going live. We're only 30 minutes into the show so far. We're going to talk about a few things happening around sports land and everything else. We're talking about Pat Summer.